devastation that you're seeing right there. I mean, you've got debris everywhere, water and water and more water, roofs peeled off indiscriminately. We're also seeing, as you get closer to the, you can see the shoreline to your right, you can see there are just boats have been thrown all over the place. Just look at the trees, torn apart. As this drone continues on through, really showing just some of the devastation that has been described to us over and over again of the hit that Fort Myers has taken. We know that so many rescues have been required. We're just talking to the Coast Guard and that they've been doing air and water rescues. People needing to be rescued from their rooftops, from what they've been dealing with. And you can see, you just hope that so many of these families got out, got to safer ground, got to higher ground, of course, as the storm was barreling through. Those streets still covered with water. You saw another image, another shot that the drone had just a moment ago. Boats capsized, thrown about, looking more like toys than hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Worrying for officials now, concerned about folks who are eager to get back and see what's left of their lives and may accidentally electrocute themselves. There have been fires that have started because of natural gas leaks. You gotta worry about snakes, you gotta worry about sewage, and maybe oil spills. This is just the beginning of such a painful stretch for so many folks. Storm. The Lee County Sheriff's Office is now reporting hundreds of fatalities in the county. The Lee County Sheriff right now is reporting hundreds of fatalities in his county. That includes cities like Fort Myers. That includes cities like Fort Myers Beach. That includes Cape Coral. We have been reporting that the storm surge was going to be catastrophic. We've been getting reports that the storm surge was right around 7 feet, and you know, this is heartbreaking to hear, because, you know, we tried as much as possible to warn people. I know that there were a number of people who unfortunately could not evacuate.
Hurricane knocked out electricity to more than 2.5 million homes and businesses. One person has been killed and many more are missing.
This could be the deadliest hurricane in Florida's history. The numbers are still unclear, but we're hearing early reports of what may be substantial loss of life.